guys and welcome back to my channel, or if you are new here, welcome. My name is Shravani and I am a certified personal trainer and sports nutritionist, and that's what my videos are generally based around. But today's video is going to be a little bit different. This is going to cover my master's program and what I did, what the program's about, because I get so many questions about this all the time, and also I personally feel like it was a great experience that I do want to share with you all. So this might be useful to you if you know you are a student right now looking to pursue your master's education, or even if you are a working professional right now with a little bit of experience and you want to go ahead and get an MBA. So I really hope you guys enjoy this video. If you do, please be sure to give me a big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button so that you never miss a video from me again. If you're wondering why my setup is a little bit different, it's because I am trying to make a few changes here and there to get y'all the best quality of videos that I can. Alright, so I really hope that this video is going to be helpful to many of you. If it does help you in any way, let me know in the comments below. Alright, so without further ado, let's get into the video. Alright, so I wanted to start this video off by giving you all a little bit of a background for those of you who don't know. I am a master's in global business and my specialization during this course was e-business. Alright, so I just wanted to sort of make that very clear to y'all before we move forward. So for the sake of this video, I actually have 2 pages full of notes just because I didn't want to miss out on anything. And I also did ask y'all on Instagram to ask me questions if you have anything specific that you'd like me to cover in this particular video. So I actually got quite a few questions, and because of this, I reached out to SPGen themselves and they were kind enough to send me an entire PowerPoint presentation about their MGB program, their GMBA program, which I'll cover in a little bit, as well as plenty of pictures and videos that are going to make this video so much better. So shout out to SPGen for that. Thank you so much for sharing all the details with me. In this video, we are going to be covering 2 of SPGen School of Global Management's programs, that is the MGB or Masters of Global Business and the GMBA, which is the Global MBA. So the first question that I get asked is, how is the MGB program different from an MBA? It isn't, it's just the name that's different. So SPGen School of Global Management is actually an Australian business school and they have campuses in Dubai, Singapore, Sydney and Mumbai. And they are the pioneers of the world's first tri-city undergraduate and postgraduate programs. They've actually been ranked amongst the world's best institutes by Forbes, Times Higher Education, Financial Times, Economist, etc. So very quickly, I'm going to break down the GMBA and the MGB program just so you guys have clarity on these 2 different sort of courses. So the GMBA, the Global MBA, is actually a 12-month full-time MBA course which covers 36 credits, and the eligibility for this program is 3+ years of work experience. So if you're someone who's been, you know, working in the industry for a while and you're now looking to go and pursue your MBA, then the GMBA is the course for you. They have 5 specializations to offer you: global logistics and supply chain management, global finance, global marketing management, technology management, and consulting management. So these are the 5 specializations offered in the GMBA, and you graduate with an Australian degree. Now moving to the MGB program, which is what I did. That is a 16-month full-time MBA, which includes 4 months of an internship. So yeah, you have to do that internship before you sort of graduate and you get your degree in hand. This also has 36 credits in total, and the eligibility is 0 to 3 years of experience. So if you're someone who's, you know, just finishing up your bachelor's and you just, you know, want to get an MBA before you actually start working, then the MGB program is the one for you. So within MGB, there are 4 specializations, that is again, global logistics and supply chain management, global marketing management, global finance, and digital business management, which at my time was called e-business. So in terms of overall career positioning, if you do the GMBA, then you can expect between like a mid-management leading up to a senior management position, depending on how much experience you've had, right? So in the GMBA, even though it says 3+, we usually have people who have, you know, sometimes we have people who have 10+ years of experience. So it's a very broad sort of category there, versus MGB is sort of, you know, people between say 21 to 25 years of age on an average. So if you do the MGB program, you can expect a placement somewhere between executive to mid-management level. Alright, so now coming to the faculty, I think that has been in my personal experience, I was absolutely blown away with the quality of professors that they have out there. Actually, 74% of their faculty are doctorate holders, and their expertise ranges from, you know, research to industry experience to consulting. So you have like a wide array of experience that these faculty bring to you, and most of them are actually super approachable, really helpful. They'll be there for you even after the course ends. So it's really nice to have these kind of mentors, you know, even after you finish a master's course. Don't worry at all, the faculty is amazing. All right, so a lot of people are worried about placements, and I think that's the question that I get asked most often, like, how are the placements like, is it worth it, and you know, something along these lines. So I'm sure you're facing the same issue as well. Let me tell you one thing, there is no business school in the world that can tell you as of today, before you start the program, what companies are going to come up 1 year from now or 1.5 years from now when you complete the program. Okay, so the companies, the opportunities that come during your placement phase really depends on the opportunities in the market at that moment. However, SPGN has sent me a few slides with their top recruiters, so I'm just going to flash them over here. Now coming to return on investment, I think that is something that is way too early for me to say right now, and also it would be a little unfair for me to comment on this at this moment, because when my batch graduated, COVID happened and we're all sort of struggling here. So I can't say for sure, but yes, I do have a student loan that I've taken up and I do have to repay that. So that is, you know, like a burden that's hanging on our head. But the college placement committee really never gives up on you. So you do have a student body that forms a PLECOM, the placement committee within the students itself, and they sort of, you know, communicate with the placement office to help get your opportunities. So even though we graduated in January, the support from college is still there. So they're not gonna just, you know, leave you, abandon you and be like, okay, we can't help you out. They're really trying their best to get us opportunities, and that is something that I really, really appreciate. All right, so I do have some statistics that I got from college about their placements over the last year or so, and I'll put them up right here for GMBA and MGB both. However, if you're someone who's just starting the program, and I have said this to the other batches as well, just about a week ago I had a call with the MGB batches that are starting off in October, and even they had a lot of placement related questions, to which I said, you know what, you've got 12 months in front of you, 12 months that are going to be so difficult but yet such an enriching experience. Like, you just need to really focus on the time that's in front of you. Do well, do what you can, and when it comes to placement, sort of leave it to college. Yeah, just focus on the things that you can control, that are in your control, your academics, the fact that you're going to be going on this amazing experience, this Tri-City program. Just really just soak it all in, because once it's done, you're really gonna miss it. It's so cliche, right? Like, after college is done, people are like, yeah, college days are like the best days of our lives. But I can't even tell you that this MBA, if someone were to ask me how it's different from any other MBA out there, I would say hands down the Tri-City experience. I think this is something that's very unique, and there are still not many universities that offer this. So this is definitely a selling point. I'll tell you the best thing about the whole Tri-City experience, okay? Like, some people might see it as, oh, you're just roaming three countries, it's like some vacation. And yeah, I mean, there are some people who come on board for that factor, but काफी expensive vacation हो जाता है वो, if you know, you don't really focus on your academics. But I'll say, you know, you're in each city for 4 months, right? And just as you get comfortable in one city, you're sort of uprooted and taken to the next. So what happens is you really learn how to adapt. You're very quick to, you know, get up and move. And that's why they call it like being a global leader, right? Because you're going to be able to move to any city in the world and be able to adapt, because you've done that 3 times before. And also, in all three countries, in all three cities, the culture is so very different that you learn the nitty-gritties of each culture in each city. So for those of you who don't know about this program, it basically allows you to study in three cities. That's mainly Dubai, Sydney and Singapore. That's how it was during my time. There have been a few changes in the program since, in which you can still opt for going through the same process that I did. So Dubai, Sydney and Singapore, 4 months each. or you can do, there are a few, you know, combinations there where you can study one term in Mumbai, then Sydney, then Singapore, or you can do two terms in Mumbai and then one term in Singapore, or you can do all three terms in Mumbai. Regardless, the faculty stays pretty much the same, so you're not really losing out on much in terms of the academics. But yeah, in terms of the experience, there may be a little bit that you might miss out on. But then again, it comes down to, you know, what your priorities are. Obviously, doing all three terms in Mumbai is going to be a little less expensive compared to doing all three terms abroad. So I do have the fee structure for all these combinations, and I'm just going to put it up here. I've got the fees for like each term separately, so I'm going to put that up on the screen right now. Alright, so now you've heard about the program, you are sold, and you're probably wondering, how do I get in, right? So let me quickly brief you all about the application process. Step one is going to be obviously submitting your application. So that is free of cost, there's no cost involved there. But it does require you to submit aptitude test score as well. And this can be GMAT, GRE, CAT, or they have their own SPGEN aptitude test called the SPCHAT. So you can give any one of these and submit your test scores along with your application. Step two is going to be the application screening. So they're going to go through your application. If they like it, they're going to call you for an interview. So that's going to be step number three. That's round three, in which, you know, there's going to be a case study, self-reflective essay. There are so many different things that go into like the actual interview and selection process. So this usually takes an entire day. At the end of the day, you have a panel interview. Sometimes you could have multiple interviews. I don't know how they decide whether you should have multiple interviews or not. Like, I personally had two interviews before I got selected. Some people had three, some people had only one. And finally, by the end of the day, once you're done with the interview, there are three possible outcomes. One, you would be accepted and you'd get an offer letter. Second would be you're on the wait list, which means, you know, they'll get in touch with you if something works out. And number three is, you know, it didn't work out, I'm sorry, but we've had to reject your application. So these are the three outcomes. Obviously, you can apply more than once. I'm not sure about the maximum number of times you can apply. For those of you wondering what the SPGEN aptitude test is like, I have information on that as well. So it's an online test in which there is diagrammatic reasoning, logic, there is IQ, there is numeracy, and there is reading comprehension. 34-35 questions and a total of 100 marks. So it's actually like any other aptitude test that you could find out there. So if you've been, you know, prepping for CAT, GMAT, all these things, it's going to be relatively along the same lines. I personally gave SPGEN to enter into SPGEN. All right, coming to the next point, it's about scholarships and financial aid. So this is also a question that many of you asked about. So yes, SPGEN does offer scholarships. I was going to say sponsorships. They do offer scholarships. They have like two categories where it goes all the way up to 10,000 USD. And the scholarships also split into like three different parts. What I mean by that is, one, they have an aptitude test based scholarship. So if you do really well in one of these aptitude tests that I mentioned before, they could offer you a scholarship on that. Second is a leadership scholarship. So this can, comes down to, you know, your past, your history, like the things that you've done, the things that you mention on your application that maybe you've done in college, maybe you've done in school. And the third one is merit scholarship. So this really depends on how your academic record has been throughout college. So I personally did have the leadership scholarship of 5,000 USD. So yes, that does make it a little bit lighter on the pocket. And obviously bank loans are available from SBI, HDFC. These banks are actually very well aware of this course, so then it makes it relatively easier to get your loan. I got my loan from HDFC Bank. All right, so now that I'm done with majority of like the heavy topics, like all the information, I wanted to, you know, just sort of talk about my personal experience. I started my MGB journey in September 2018, so it's been 2 years. I cannot believe it's been 2 years. Like, you know how Instagram reminds you about things you've posted today 1 year ago, 2 years ago? So Instagram just reminded me today that I was at the Burj Khalifa 2 years ago at this spot, and I just cannot believe how time flies. I started off in Dubai, obviously, and I had personally never been to Dubai, so this was, it was always on my list. I always wanted to visit. So that was great, you know, sort of going there. And I'm going to talk a lot about the accommodation and stuff as well, because I know y'all have those questions. I'm going to insert lots of pictures, so don't worry at all. So we started off in Dubai. The accommodation is in a hostel in an area known as International City, and it's within the China cluster. So the hostels are great. I mean, it's in a building with security and all of that, so you actually can't get guests in, like it's only for students. You either get a 3-person accommodation or a 5-person accommodation. I'm not sure if that has changed, you know, since COVID. Maybe, you know, there might not be as many people in a room as there used to be, but I personally went for the 3-person accommodation. So we had one big room in which, you know, we had 3 beds, a table for each of us, we had a cupboard for each of us, and we had like a tiny little cooking counter under which, you know, there was a washing machine as well. And we had a bathroom, it had a bathtub, it had everything, literally everything you can imagine. A very cute little, almost like a studio, right, for 3 people. We also did have a balcony, so that's where we used to, you know, hang our clothes. And Dubai is just so hot that we had clothes drying in like 1 hour. It was insane, like you don't even need a dryer there. So college is about 20 minutes away from where, you know, you'll be staying in Dubai. To get there, you don't have to worry at all. They do have like buses arranged by SPJ that come pick you up every morning. Coming to food in Dubai, near the accommodation, you have a lot of these small cafes that deliver food till 2 a.m. at night. Now, if you are from India, you go to Dubai, it's the most amazing thing about that place is you can sit in a cab and go like, bhaiya Dubai mall le lo. Like, I found that very amusing. I hadn't been to Dubai before, as I said, so that's great. You know, it feels like a mini India, so you don't really feel like you're away from home at all. The campus in Dubai is also beautiful, air conditioned. We've got a great canteen nearby, even though some of the food there is a little bit expensive, but you have the option of cooking at home, so you can always pack your meals. But let's be real, that doesn't really happen with student life. Oh, and I completely forgot to tell you all about the 5-person accommodation. So if you opt for the 5-person accommodation, if they're still doing that right now, I'm not sure, then you actually have like a bedroom and a separate kitchen. So basically you enter the house and you have like a relatively large kitchen there, and then you have a bedroom in which there are 2 beds, and then like a hall kind of area where there are 3 beds. So that one is like quite spacious, and you have 2 bathrooms there and also a balcony. So once you're done with your 4 months in Dubai, you move over to Sydney, Australia, which was another place that I had never been to, so it was very, very exciting. We reached our accommodation, which is fantastic. I think we had the best apartments in Sydney. So we have like a proper apartment building with like, you have to have a card and you tap in, otherwise you can't get into the building at all. And for 3 of us, so me and 2 of my roommates, we had like a 1 BHK sort of a layout. So if you have like 4 people in a room, then you get a 2 BHK. And that was, I think, the most beautiful accommodation we had, because we had like a massive kitchen counter. We had like an island, sort of an island. We had the best kind of oven, and we also had a superb balcony from which, you know, we had a spectacular view every day. So accommodation was absolutely fantastic in Sydney. A drawback there was that, you know, when you just come from Dubai and you're so used to getting transport from college, Sydney doesn't offer that. So the campus is located in Olympic Park in Sydney, and that's about, I would like to say, maybe half an hour away from our accommodation. And we would initially take the train, then we start taking the bus, and eventually we start taking the cab, because public transport in Australia is a little bit expensive, and we found that if 4 people sort of just chip in, the cost of the cab is almost equivalent to the amount that you would spend via public transport on your own. I think in terms of food, there was an Indian store nearby, and thankfully I had someone in my group who cooked amazing food, so we never had a problem of, you know, like Indian food. But otherwise, if you go to Indian restaurants there, they are good but relatively expensive. But I think the best part about Australia, it's not related to the MGV program at all, it was the drives. So even though the course is a bit intensive, you do, you know, once in a while you're able to squeeze out some time to just get all your friends together, rent a car and go on these beautiful drives. The Grand Pacific Drive is one that we did. That was, I think, the first drive we did when we reached Sydney, and it completely blew my mind. It's like Australia has so many beautiful landscapes, it's insane. And after that, we also did do a couple more road trips. We also went to Tasmania in like a long weekend that we had. So you can always sort of, you know, squeeze out some time. And then we move on to Singapore, which was, I was very excited to go back because for those of you who don't know, I grew up there. I spent a fair amount of time in Singapore. I was there for 12 years. So my childhood has sort of gone in that country. So I'm very, very attached to Singapore. So I was naturally very excited to go back. The campus in Singapore is actually very beautiful. Lots of greenery around. And the best part about the Singapore campus is that you literally live in the same building as your classes. So yeah, that means getting up, brushing your teeth and going to attend your classes. So I think that was the most convenient thing. Like after, you know, rushing to class in Sydney, this became very convenient where we could just get up 5 minutes before and just run to class. And yeah, they're very strict about attendance and it's biometric attendance. So you have to be in class at like 9:29 or 9:31 and you miss your attendance, you know, things like that. So we struggled with that a bit in Sydney. In Singapore, it was relatively easier. In Singapore, we had, I think, 3-person accommodations and 4-person accommodations. So you just have, it's a relatively smaller room. So it's just one single room with beds, cupboards and a table for each of you. And there's like a common pantry area with like a microwave. So they do have like a veg and non-veg microwave, a toaster, you've got a kettle there and a few common fridges. So you can just sort of store your food if you get anything from outside. But yeah, there's no facility to cook within your room. So that was a bit of a drawback. For washing your clothes, there is a washer and dryer. I think there are about 3 or 4 washers and dryers on each floor. And within campus, there is a Kamath restaurant. So that's where most people would eat. So you do get Indian food there daily. So nothing to worry about. They also do have a small canteen in which, you know, you can get waffles and Milo and other things to just sort of keep you going. And apart from that, it's located very near Harbourfront, which has like an amazing mall called Vivo City. So we would literally be there every other day. It's a great location actually. Even like downtown is relatively close from where SPGen is located. Singapore's public transport system is A1. It's absolutely phenomenal. You can get from any point to any point in the country without much hassle at all. I think by the time you get to the third term, the pressure sort of starts building up. This is where you start, you know, worrying about placements. But the placement opportunities start coming in around the 10th month that you are in the course. And then some people, you know, get placed immediately and then they start their internships right after. And some people have to wait a couple of months before they start. And once you're done with 4 months of your internship, a compulsory internship, you graduate. So I know this video has gone on and on and on, but I just wanted to cover like everything into this video so that it's able to deliver a good amount of knowledge to y'all. And now at this point, I'm going to quickly take up some questions just to check whether I've missed out on anything. I've taken screenshots of what you guys asked me on Instagram, so let me just see if there's anything I've missed out so I can quickly cover that up and wrap up this video. Okay, so someone's asked, how many classes do you have per day? So usually you will have 2 classes per day. So that goes on from about 9:30 a.m. to around 4:30 in the evening, 9:30 to about 4. I don't remember the exact duration anymore, but you have about 2 classes a day. Sometimes you might have 3. Someone else has asked about life in Sydney. I think I've covered a bit of that already, but I want to point out one thing that I found very different about Sydney that we didn't necessarily like. Okay, so having like coming from a place like Mumbai, which is alive literally all the time, like it never sleeps, right? You go to Sydney and then suddenly everything shuts at 5 p.m. I'm not even exaggerating, like even malls, we would reach malls and then by like 5:30 they'd have their shutters down. Okay, so what someone has asked me, what's the best part of the program? I would say the overall experience. You know, coming from an engineering background wherein in college, in bachelor's, things were quite chill. Like there could be an assignment given to me today, which was due for tomorrow, and I could submit it a couple of weeks later. It just was that way. But then when you go for an MBA like this, you've got an assignment today and you have to submit it by like 12 midnight the same day. And these things are done online. So there's no handing in of papers. It's just the link expires and that's it, you lose your marks, right? Also, there are a lot of activities that college also arranges. Like for example, in Dubai, they took us to the top of Burj Khalifa. In Sydney, they took us surfing. In Singapore, they took us dragon boat racing. And I'm just naming, you know, one of the many events that they held. Another question I get is about co-curricular activities. So if you guys, if your batch is vocal about what you all want to do, then college will help you out with that. So in my case, in Dubai, we played a lot of basketball. We even went for a tournament, so that was great. We got jerseys made and stuff, so college was really supportive about that. Similarly, in Singapore, we did like a intra-college sort of a tournament as well. That was really fun too. So we had basketball, we had football, we had tug of war and stuff like that. And we also had a Diwali party in which some of us performed. So yeah, it really depends on, you know, what you guys want and how vocal you are about it. All right, so the rest of the questions are really around, are sort of revolving around the fees and, you know, whether it's worth it or not because the fees are high. So I would say, you know, undoubtedly it is a little bit expensive. I'm not gonna lie about that, but overall I felt like the experience, I can't put a price on it. It was unbelievable. Like, and I know that there are other people who have other opinions, but I personally feel like no matter what course you opt for, you are always going to have some sort of problems with the faculty, with the staff, with the curriculum, with the exam pattern. You will always have something to complain about. I think that's just us as students. It's just like second nature to us, right? But I'm trying to put this out in the most unbiased way possible, that this program is going to teach you so much, you won't even realize it. It's only when you really complete the course and you look back, and that's when you'll see how much of a difference it's made. It has definitely caused like a 360 degree change in my point of view. I think 2 years ago, I was somebody struggling with computer science, not knowing what I wanted to do in the future because I didn't enjoy the course I was in, to having established Team Meraki with two of my closest people in this world. I think that drive, that confidence is something that the MBA gave me, and it has the potential to do that for you as well. So I would definitely 100% recommend this course to you, and I'm not saying this because college has asked me to. They didn't even know I was doing this video. I reached out to them. So please take this as a genuine, honest feedback from my side. Apart from this, if you have any more questions, I'll be more than happy to take them. I'm gonna leave my email address down below so that you can contact me there, or obviously you can DM me on Instagram. I would love to have a chat with you to discuss anything, any of these things in further detail. All right, so I have about 45 minutes of footage to edit right now. I don't know how all my videos end up being so long, but hopefully this video was detailed enough to give you a good enough picture of how the course is like. Maybe it will even help you make a decision whether you want to go for this course or not. I can't sit here and compare this course or this college to any other college. I can only speak from my personal experience, and to me, it's been a 10 on 10. hope you all enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please let me know in the comments below. Subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button, share it with your friends and family, do all those wonderful things, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.